Hello, everybody. I'm back. You probably are like, Casey, what the fuck are you just talking about? You literally just uploaded last Sunday. I actually haven't filmed the video in a while because I've literally been dying over exams and just many deadlines, and I just... November wasn't the month. It really wasn't the month for me. And today, I'm so happy because I'm basically done all of the work that I've literally been stressing over for the past month, and I finally get to sit down and just film like a fun video, and I'm just really excited about it. Honestly, I wanted to react to this trailer immediately when it came out, but I just had like literally three group projects, like presentation style, that I had to do, and on top of that also two exams. It was a lot. I genuinely just couldn't sit down and film it, but we're here today. And listen, before anybody hits me with,
"You're just doing this because it's trending on YouTube," or "You're just doing this because all YouTubers are doing it."
No. I have a very personal connection with After, and you're probably wondering, Casey, what is that connection? Because I don't really talk about it on my YouTube, but if you follow me on Twitter, you've probably caught on to this. I've become more comfortable with just being like, hey guys, this is me. At least on my personal. But anyway, back when I was a little fetus, back in 2011 to up until 2014, 2015, I was a 1D stan account. And probably most of you know that After was a fanfic for Harry Styles. And I had some choice thoughts about it. I actually went back onto my account and searched After because I wanted to see. I knew that I had hated it when it came out because all of my friends were like, oh my god, this is so amazing, you have to read it. Like, I was in the trenches when Imaginator 1D was like, new chapter this week, guys. Like, I was there, and I actively chose not to read it because it was so bad. Some of my favorite tweets that I said were, "I'm pretty sure the girl writing After is only still writing it because the minute she stops, no one's gonna care anymore," which was in reference to the fact that, I kid you not, this series had like 450 chapters. It was ridiculous, and every single chapter was basically the same thing regurgitated every single chapter. I said the After fanfic, Harry does something wrong, Tessa cries, Harry gets mad, Harry apologizes, Tessa gives him one more chance, repeat. It was true though, that shit was bad, like actually so fucking bad. I remember the last time that I checked on it, it had 280 chapters. 280 chapters. So while I did initially not think that I should do this video because I was like, okay, the hype is already passed, everyone knows it's shit, there was a part of me, like, 2013 or 2012 when this was all going down? Hold on. Yeah, 2013, Casey, she was in there and she was like, listen, you owe it to me, okay? You owe this to me to react to this trailer. So that's what we're gonna do today. Alright, so I'm gonna, like, scoot a little bit. Also, I'm wearing the penis sweater, which, if you didn't watch my vlog, this cat has a penis. Like, there's five things on this cat, but I can't tell which one is the leg and which one is the penis. It's... someone please tell me what the fuck is going on.
There are moments in our lives that seem to define us.
She's there, there.
Are you a virgin?
I dare you.
First of all, can we just talk, okay, if you haven't read the book, or okay, I can't even say I read the whole book, I read like, I kid you not, maybe 20 chapters. Tessa was so determined to make sure everyone knew she was a virgin. Like, literally you could be like, hey,
I'm a virgin. Did you know I'm a virgin? Did you know that?
I don't know why. Also, this guy looks like he's 40. I don't know why he's in this. He also looks like he's going through a midlife crisis. Why is his hair blonde? This is really weird.
I'm done playing.
I can't take this seriously. She also looks like Lily from Riverdale, or Betty from Riverdale, played by Lily Reinhart.
In this game, but
also kind of sounds like her too.
What lies beyond those moments?
Okay, my main issue is this guy is a terrible actor. Like, can we just go back? Look at how awkward this scene is. Like, just look. He just appears.
Beyond those moments.
What are you doing?
Even the way he talks, it's so weird. It's like somebody cut the audio in just the most awkward way. He literally is just like,
what are you doing?
I think you owe me a death.
How much did they pay Ariana? to give the rights to this song is my question. Like, did they go, listen, we'll give you a lot of money? Or did they say, can we use your song? And her team was like, well, what do you want it for? And they just went, just a movie trailer. Like, it's not that. Like, there's no way. There is no way her team saw this trailer and went, yeah, you can use our song. Like, this is just horrendous.
So, what's his story?
Be careful. Pardon is complicated.
They didn't even change the name. Like, okay, why? Why? I remember when this, like, fanfic first came out and everyone was talking about it, I'm like, why the fuck did they name him Harden? And on top of that, why would you keep that name? Who names their child Harden? Where did that come from? Like, can you imagine carrying a child for, I don't know how long you carry a child. Is it 9 months? I'm showing how stupid I am. But carrying a child, giving birth to it, and then them going, ma'am, what would you like to name your kid? And you're like, Harden.
What are you dreaming about?
His acting is so bad! Everything about this is so awkward! Like, just his dialogue. What is this? What are you dreaming about? This man has, like, two facial expressions at the most and has no, like, nothing. He just talks in monotone. What are you dreaming about? What are you doing? I think you owe me a dare. It's literally just, have you ever seen that tweet where it's like, Nicholas Sparks videos or book covers are literally just white people embracing? Like, that's literally this entire trailer. All of this, it's the same thing.
My life before him was so simple, and now there's just after.
Also, what is this font? I'm sorry, what is this font? Like, I know I sound like a typo, like, I sound like a dick, like, picking on the font of all things, but there's just something about a bad font that just makes things so much worse. Like, think about a movie poster with, like, a good font, and think about how, like, the font makes it. Like, for example, Jaws, good font. After, fucking awful. Literally makes it 10 times worse. Also, pretty sure they only got the rights for the first 30 seconds of Dangerous Woman because that's all they played in this entire fucking trailer. What theater is taking this movie? Like, who is seeing this? Who is seeing this? Like, obviously I understand the book has a fan base, but to actually sit there and say it has a large enough fan base for a theater release, think about the kinds of movies that get, like, a restricted theater release. Lady Bird. Call Me By Your Name had a restricted release at the beginning. Beautiful Boy had a restricted release at the beginning. You're trying to tell me that After has the same amount of an audience as those movies. Is that what you're trying to tell me right now? Like, this is bad. This is really bad. But the only thing that's worse is the fact that I know that somehow this trailer is going to be better than whatever the fuck they are cooking up for Hush Hush. Like, I know. Like, I'm watching this. We see the, like, low budget kind of, like, who is this man? What is his hair? Also, why does he have a buzz cut? Like, I'm very confused. You would keep the name that was meant to be, like, as close to Harry as possible when you could have named him Harold. Or, I don't know, like, something else. Like, Henry. Just something that didn't sound, like, dumb. But then you choose to have him have short hair, even though the most identifiable trait of is his hair. Honestly, I'm probably going to end up watching this movie because my group of friends, like, we all were 1D stands and we, like, grew up kind of, like, with it all. So it's kind of one of those things that you have to do, like, going to Thanksgiving, even though, like, that side of the family that's kind of weird, but you're like, we gotta go. We gotta do it. I gotta sit through an hour and a half of this bullshit. It's basically the same thing. So I don't know, maybe I'll do like a movie review. That honestly sounds like so much work, and I don't know if I'm going to be awake during the whole movie to actually pay attention. Also, where was Pia Mia? She's been repping this movie like hard, which was kind of surprising because it's like, are you trying to be a singer or like a C-list actor? Maybe get on the Hallmark Channel. This is very Hallmark Channel, but like trying to be 50 Shades of Grey, but like still Hallmark Channel, if you know what I mean. I don't know. It is what it is. Anyway, I found some more tweets from my time reading After, so I thought I would share them. Because, I don't know, it's just a nice trip down memory lane, and I also realized this video is going to be unbelievably short. I think my personal favorite is, I've read the first paragraph of After, and I'm concerned on whether the girl who wrote it is illiterate. At least we know, like, my brand is consistent. This was how many? Oh my god, that's like over, that's 5 years ago. Whoa. See? I'm consistent at least. Oh my god, I was so cringy. I literally said the ending of After should be Harry dumping Tessa as he drives away saying, ooh, kill him. Oh, that was really bad. Okay, it was Vine times though, okay? Like, let me live. Oh, this one's really fucking cringy too. I said the After update is Harry snapping and being all like, Tessa, shut the fuck up, you annoying ass bitch. Fuck this shit, I'm gonna go bang Molly. Then it ends. I don't even remember who Molly was. Why do I... Isn't that like someone, hold on, I think that was like a girl that liked Harry and like tried to put herself on Harry and like Harry was like, not Harry, Harden. Why do they talk weird and After? I will see you soon. I will go here. I will do this. Like just write, see you soon. I'm going here. Like, points were made. Anyways, guys, I hope that you enjoyed this more kind of like chill, laid back video. It was kind of nice to just sit in front of a camera and like just be like, let's react to some dumb fucking shit because it's fun. If you're excited for the After movie, please don't get offended. It's just my opinion. It doesn't matter that much. I promise you it doesn't matter that much. And yeah, if you like this video, feel free to like and subscribe. If you want to follow me outside of YouTube, you can check me out on Instagram or Twitter. And leave any video suggestions you guys have down in the comments down below that don't involve me reading a book because my brain literally cannot handle reading any collection of words for at least 7 more business weeks. And yeah, thank you again for watching and I'll see you guys in the next one.